Hello and welcome to Yeyu Lab. Today we're going to explore a new technique that has the potential to make AI applications smarter than ever. This technique is called StepBack Prompting and has exciting implications in the development of LLM applications. Let's consider a simple chemistry question and see how a well-performed model LAMA270B responds. Assuming a complete reaction between 2 moles of nitrogen and 4 moles of hydrogen to produce ammonia, the task is to predict which will get exhaust first. Although an LLM model such as LAMA V2 is aware of a chemistry equation involved, it's forced to predict accurately which reactant exhausts first. The reason why? It probably does not comprehend the real implication of exhaustion in a complete reaction. Also, when I make a search-based chatbot asking some NBA question, like who has played more All-Star games between Ben Simmons and Leonard, it looks the answer is still wrong. Even I give it access to internet search. This may make you wonder how such a decent model struggles with a relatively straightforward question. Humans, when asked a complex question, often opt to step back and make abstractions to the principle and high-level concepts. Borrowing from this insight, Google DeepMind now processed a new strategy, step-back prompting. Step-back prompting is a quite effective strategy as it makes the LLM to first generate a step-back question about the high-level concepts or principles before addressing the original question. This method is also referred to as abstraction and reasoning. It requires an LLM to retreat from a specific example, derives general level high-level abstraction context from the step-back questions, and then use this context to guide its problem-solving approach. There's a significant difference between regular reasoning and step-back prompting, as illustrated in the paper from Google DeepMind. When a language model using regular reasoning was tested with a factual question about a certain person and her association with educational background, Estella Leopold, I don't know much about her, but seems a great natural scientist. The answer was incorrect. Surprisingly, the language model using step-back prompting first abstracted the initial question and then asked a step-back question like, what was Estella Leopold's educational history? When you look at the result, a much more accurate response without depending heavily on the LLM generation capability. Google's statistics revealed how, in most cases, the PaLM-2L model outperforms the GPT-4 when the step-back prompting technique is incorporated. Compare the green bar to blue bar. The green bar competes the blue bar in physics, chemistry, time QA, music, and strategy QA. The performance enhancement to be up to 36%. With these encouraging results, I'm going to test step-back prompting on the LAMA2 model for its real-world problem-solving ability. This demo is to create an advanced QA system with the LAMA V270B chat model and a chatlink-based evaluation app. In this app, we can evaluate how step-back prompting truly enhanced the language model's performance. The app is divided into 2 parts, the step-back question chain and the retrieval LLM chain. The first step-back question chain uses a user query and a few examples to formulate principal questions. The GPT-3.5 model in this section generates more accurate and valuable questions by passing these abstracted questions. This output is then processed into a list of formatted output parser for easy extraction for the next steps. The second retrieval LLM chain uses the questions generated just now to generate internet content with the DuckDuckGo API. Also, you can choose other commercial search API like Brave Search or SERP API for better performance. And this content is then combined with the original user query to formulate a final answer. And please note that the Llama V270B chat model is inferred from the platform called Fireworks AI that was used for this experiment. All right, let's move to coding. First of all, we will start with setting up. And this includes installing the required dependencies and importing necessary modules. As you do this, make sure you've assigned your API keys in environment variable. You will need keys for OpenAI and Fireworks AI, and also creating two chat instances. Fireworks AI is a platform that provides fast inference API for various open source language models, including Llama 2. After signing up, you will get $1 credit for using their API, and it's quite enough to do hundreds of inference tests for free. You can create your API key as well as find more open models in your Fireworks account. Next, we will move to constructing a StepBack questions chain. A critical step here is guiding the language model to generate StepBack questions using a prompt template with a few short examples. Here, I extended the original examples from LangChain demo. You can see for every single question, there will be two answers attached, separated by a comma. Moving forward, we will construct our first chain, question gen chain, to generate these step back questions. You'll be able to test the quality of step back question generation so that you can iterate and improve it further. Define the chemistry question we saw before, invoke the chain with this question. Here is the printed output. It generated two principal questions about the chemistry for the original question's background in the format of a string list. Once the chain can generate these step back questions, it's time to answer them. And that's where the retrieval LLM chain comes in. We will define a help function to search for the questions from the string list that consolidates the search result. We then added this search result linking to the question gen chain into our prompt with the name step back context. Here we use the Llama 2 model from Chat Fireworks API. Before wrapping up the application coding, a critical part here is constructing our app with an additional normal reasoning chain, which will serve as a baseline to compare the performance of the step back strategy. Here we still call it step back context, but actually it's just retrieving the original question from search. Once we've done all the work, it's time to give our app a user-friendly UI with a nice framework. We will do that using chainlit. The process is super simple and quick with chainlit. It proves the convenience of our app significantly. Step one, move the chain's definition code under the decorator cl.onChatStart. Don't forget to export two chains, the chain and the chain node step, to user session for use across the web sessions. Step two, implement the onMessage decorator to handle incoming user import. Load and call the two chains and print the generated answers on the screen. To run the chainlit on your terminal, simply type chainlit command, then visit the local host port 8000 on your browser. For this original chemistry query, the two answers are opposite. in the summary generated by StepBack Prompting, the chatbot said the hydrogen will get exhausted first, which was apparently correct. Unfortunately, the generation with normal prompting looked to misunderstand the question and then provided the wrong answer that nitrogen will be all reacted. Okay, you've successfully coded for StepBack Prompting using the Llama 2 model. Also, to make further improvement for your real QA project, you can use other search tools for better search results. Look at how it shows a model becomes more knowledgeable with Brave Search API for NBA question. It separately asks a question about the two players about their experience of All-Star Games and generated the right answer. That's all for today. For the tutorial and the source code, you can find the link in the description below. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. Keep innovating, and I'll catch you in the next one.